There was once a young lady who happened to hit the Powerball. You might have heard about it, 1.5 million, something like that, billion. And what, as chance would have it, she went out and bought the home of her dream. Many rooms, chandeliers, great, everything to her liking, except for one thing, the view. See, outside of her house, the view was a big mountain. She, as she went and laid down at night, she began to read in her Bible, and she came across the passage that said that all you have to have is a faith the size of a mustard seed. And say to that mountain, be ye mountain removed, it should be done. So she did this. And I mind you, with very little confidence. And the very next day, as she looked out of her window again, she saw that same mountain. And she said to herself, I knew it would still be there. Do we know people like that? Doubt.
Yes.
Doubt is the biggest killer of belief. And all it takes is just a little bit. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Toastmasters and guests, I'm here to tell you tonight that there's power in believing. There's power in believing. See, when people start to believe, things start to happen. I want you to think back to when you're just a little kid. I'll give you just a little longer so some people can get there. I want you to get there. Just the time you was a little kid, outside playing, maybe riding your bike, your skateboard, roller skateboard, and you fall and bruise your elbow or your knee, and you go in crying to your mom. And what does mom do? Gives her a little kiss and says it'll be better. And although there's no medicine in that kiss, the power of believing dictates that pain starts to go away. Many doctors will give their patients what's called a placebo. And all a placebo is maybe just a sugar pill. No power in it. No power. But they give it to their patients and say that it'll cure their ailment, whatever it may be. See, nothing happens at that point. But once it's received, see, we receive it because we give that doctor a certain level of authority. We give our parents a certain level of authority. We give our friends a certain level of authority. And when they tell us something, we tend to believe it. So that doctor, when that doctor gives a placebo pill, we give a belief in that authority. We believe in that authority. What happens when you believe in a higher authority? See, I know many people, and we all probably know people that doctors have given unfavorable reports. But see, that person doesn't accept that as authority. Some people will receive their authority straight from the Most High. And even though that doctor says it's time to start making the final arrangements, because that person has already made up in his mind that they're going to make it, they're going to pull through, they're going to have that testimony at the end of this test, because the person has already made up in their mind, ladies and gentlemen, the power of belief, very powerful. Many years ago, actually back before 1954, it was presumed that to run a mile in less than 4 minutes is impossible. Impossible. But there was one gentleman by the name of Roger Bannister. He believed in a different authority. He said that it is possible. Even though the doctors had laid out the reports, all the smart people, all the intelligent people that came together and got their data together that said it's impossible for the human body to endure what it takes to get to a 4 minute mile. Despite this, Roger Bannister still pushed through. And on May 6, 1954, he completed that mile in 3 minutes and 59 seconds. And as he crossed that finish line, he collapsed with doubt. Maybe that little bit of doubt kicked in. Maybe he started to believe those reports that if the person was to be able to complete that feat, then they would surely die. But when he came to them, he realized he did it. He broke that mile barrier in 3 minutes and 59 seconds. Once thought to be impossible, but the power of belief. Now that he's done that, the mile has been beaten now by more than 14 seconds faster than what they first presumed that it could be. So when we start to believe things, things start to happen. Sometimes in life, we don't believe in our own selves. And I remember when I went to the Marine Corps. Prior to the Marine Corps, my life wasn't too great. I thought I knew everything and ended up homeless in life. My belief system said that I was unworthy of God's best. That was what I believed until I went to the United States Marine Corps. There's a passage that I adopted, Romans 12:2. It says, "Be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind." See, when we begin to change our thoughts, things begin to happen. And let me explain the power of belief. And how do we get to belief? Belief is no more than a thought that we continue to have. A thought that we continue to have. Anybody remember the little engine that could? The little engine that could, it's probably the best example of what I'm talking about. Even though it was hard. See, my life in the beginning, it was hard. But I remember somebody said, if you do not what's easy, later on, life will be hard. And I learned that the hard way. But it said, if you do now what's hard, later on, life will be easy. See, that little engine that could took the hard road. As it began to go up that hill, I think I can. 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 You see, think turns to belief. Belief turns to knowing. And when you know a certain thing, when you know a certain thing, you start to act in a way that may not seem rational to other people. Living by faith. See, I can't talk belief without talking faith. Faith is that thing that we can't see, but we know it's possible. By knowing, we take an action again that may seem a little irrational to other people. But our knowing, that power of believing, sets into action. Sets into action. One of my favorite movies, The Help. Anybody ever seen the movie The Help? Mm-hmm. One of my favorite movies. One of my favorite scenes in this movie. I believe it was Abilene. Sat little May on her lap. And she began to speak power into her. And she began to rock on her lap. She began to say, "He was smart. He was kind. And he was important. He was kind. He was smart. And he was important." See, what she began to do with little May, she began to build little May up. See, that's what we have to do in life. We have to build each other up. And that's what she began to do. So how many parents have taught their kids, told their kids what's possible, and didn't believe it themselves? I remember hearing, you can be, do, or have anything you want. But I also remember having a conversation with fellow classmates. As we began to discuss the possibility of having an African-American president. Imagine telling your kid they can be anything, but you don't believe it. But on January 20th, 2009, when President Barack Obama was sworn into office, that changed what was possible. That set the bar much higher than it used to be. That set belief in people. See, that's the power in belief. And so now we have kids that see that, who are now going to be doctors, who are now going to be lawyers, who are now going to be productive citizens of this great country. Sometimes that's what it takes. Belief. There's a power. And belief. Mr. Toastmaster.